everybody, and welcome to the first Planet Coaster episode of Longshore Studios. Today we are going to be building a Arrow Hypercoaster, the Arrow being the manufacturer, fully known as Arrow Dynamics. So this is the start of the Studios Park. So it is a Studios Park, so you're probably wondering, why am I building an Arrow Hypercoaster in a Studios Park? It's just like an entrance ride that's kind of loosely themed. You'll see as I go through, I could have done a better job of the theming, and I'll probably change it in the future. But yeah, this is an Arrow Hypercoaster that we're building. So you're probably wondering, what is a hypercoaster? Basically, it's a coaster of over 200 feet with no inversions. It must have no inversions to be classed as a hypercoaster. And it's kind of got a particular layout with a lot of airtime. So, say you had a launch coaster of over 200 foot, that wouldn't be a hypercoaster, because that would be kind of a different type of layout. And a good example of that is Stealth at Fort Park. It's 205 feet tall, I believe, but it's actually an accelerator coaster because of its layout with the launch and the top pattern. That, so you can see me building in the hill. So Arrow Hypercoasters, one of the most well-known ones, if you're from the UK like I am, is the big one at Blackpool Pleasure Beach, which is the only hypercoaster in the UK, opening in 1994, and I believe it was one of the first ones as well. I believe the first hypercoaster ever was an Arrow Hypercoaster. B&M make a lot of the newer ones, but I decided to do an Arrow one for this, because for, as you'll see the theme later, the kind of the trains on the Arrow Hypercoasters are kind of better suited. Also, trains on hypercoasters also have a lap bar. You're not often very strapped in on a hypercoaster. Strapped in enough so it's safe, obviously, but not often very well strapped in. Basically, that's to allow for the airtime. However, the big one at Blackpool Pleasure Beach, I've never actually ridden it. You can see me just doing a bit of a test out there. Never actually ridden it yet. I'm hoping to in a few weeks when I go. If you watched my last video, you'll know I'm heading to the Pleasure Beach in a few weeks. The big one does not have a lot of airtime apparently, and you can tell from POV. You got the first drop, which is quite incredible, and then after that you got barely anything. I wanted this to be thrilling all the way through. Yeah, there's a few sections that are less intense, but you'll see, or hopefully have seen while I'm building it, or see soon, that there is a massive overbank turn on this hypercoaster, which I don't believe is usually present on Arrow Hypercoasters, but obviously it's a Studios Park, it's about the movies. I decided to, I don't know, make this an innovative ride, because kind of the theme of this park's gonna be innovative, because although it is a movie park, a lot of my rides are gonna be kind of, yeah, themed to stuff that could be in a movie, but not, it's not gonna be based off anything in real life. And I know you're probably gonna be thinking, what on earth, but I am not the biggest fan of movies, and yeah, I've watched some Disney movies, especially like Star Wars and that. To be honest, I only got into like movies and that quite recently. I've watched a good few Star Wars films, but apart from that, I've not watched that many movies. But yeah, I didn't want this to be themed to Disney, because there's already enough Disney themed parks in the world. But what I mean by movies, to be honest, is like the Universal movies. But this park is going to be better than Universal, because we're not going to have screens everywhere. So yeah, and it's not going to be filmed to any Universal movies, because to be honest, a lot of the rides at Universal, I'm not mentioning this, but maybe another reason why a lot of the rides at Universal don't appeal to me is because I'm not into the movies that much. I couldn't really relate to any of the stuff that's happening on the rides. Obviously it was like cool and that, but I couldn't really relate to it anyway. Whereas Disney, although I not watch many of the films, I just know a lot of the stories because I've been like around Disney so much. So although I'm not watching them, I kind of know the backstories of most Disney films. But kind of Marvel and that, I don't know a lot about, to be honest. You can see me there building in the brake run. And I'm sure that any of you have been on the big one can see how much this coaster looks like it. But I actually do change this coaster to a turquoise colour. I've debated that since, but I suppose because this roller coaster, might as well reveal it, is themed to like a VIP ride on an aeroplane, and because kind of, I know it's lame, but like the sky's blue, I thought because I wanted this to be like a ride where you're focusing on kind of the views and that, I thought I'd make this like coaster like turquoise so it'd blend in with the sky quite well. Yeah, a lot of the times I choose the colour of my coasters depending on kind of their theme, so that's where I went with kind of this one, and you can see me there now, I've changed the colour of the coaster. I believe that track looks a bit darker than it did finally, but maybe that's just me. There I am building in the station using a darker kind of blue colour. You can see I've got some windows there. And you'll see me later actually put a bit of a billboard in kind of the station. What I do is I actually exit out of Planet Coaster and basically I make like a little movie kind of slideshow. So yeah, what this ride's going to be like then. So you're going to go in the entrance. I'll kind of explain it while this is being built. And then what I'll do afterwards is I'll kind of stop talking and then so you can watch what I'm talking about being built, because I just thought it's easy to get it over and done with earlier, even though I'm not actually building that part of the ride. Right, so you enter the queue, just kind of wind around, you go through kind of this entranceway with these two watchtowers, which I'm quite impressed with building. I know they're probably not that fancy, but I mean they're not that fancy, sorry. Yeah, definitely not that fancy, but I've never used kind of the circular pieces in Planet Coaster, so it's my first time. That's why they didn't look that posh, but they're kind of like made of sandstone or something. I can't entirely remember what I made of. You can see me putting the station lighting in there, which like looks quite good. Yeah, this is a really kind of night ride coaster. I mean, there is theming, but there's not that much to look at. As much as I wanted. I will add some more theming later, I think, because as time's gone on, I've decided, and if in comparison to my other eyes, I decided that this isn't really my favourite thing I've built. I've built better than this, but this is a heavily themed park anyway, so it shouldn't matter too much. This is probably going to be the one ride at the park that looks a bit tacky, and the one that gets refurbished a lot. So you can see me saving there and exiting. And what I do now is I actually go and get an image, which I put in paint, that I believe I got earlier, as like an advertisement for basically like, I know it's a bit of a Charlie Chocolate Factory ripoff, but some sort of golden ticket thing that I don't even know how people win. But yeah, it's only loosely themed this ride anyway, so I guess it doesn't matter. If there was a pre-show or something, then that might actually matter more, but there's not with this ride, so it's not too bad. And I know what you're thinking. You see, I've gone into Windows Movie Maker to make this. I have changed my editing software since to VSDC, the free version of that, but that time I just used Movie Maker. I only changed recently. Sometimes I actually use both Movie Maker and VSDC nowadays. Like, I put this video into Movie Maker, but I am going to use VSDC later probably, because I think it's better for layers. I don't know, it kind of depends what sort of video I'm doing. I think for time lapses Movie Maker is good. I think Movie Maker is better for time lapses, as it's simpler. And in VSDC, when I tried to do a time lapse, the program actually lagged a bit, so I wasn't sure if it was actually going to work properly. It was lagging like crazy. I'm not sure why. If anyone knows how to fix that issue, then please put a comment below, as VSDC is kind of better overall, as it is actually better for other aspects such as loading in videos. Like when I was doing my Movie Maker, I had to wait ages for some of the videos to load in. So if you could tell me how to fix the lagging issue with VSDC in terms of a time lapse, so your videos don't lag, then please drop a comment below, because it will be much appreciated, as VSDC is going to make editing a lot quicker for future videos, if I know how to do that. Also, if there is no way to fix that lag, then please comment whether my video will actually work as a time lapse or not. I believe VSDC can make time lapses, but it's just, I'm not sure if it was meant to lag how it was, and I didn't want to risk making a full video and then having to go back and redo it in Movie Maker because it didn't work for some weird reason, and that lag actually was a problem once I exported the file. Anyway, let me explain. Because that kind of took longer than I expected and went a bit off track, I've actually got into building the queue line now. So you got the entrance, you go through, you see some like aeroplanes. It's meant to be like an aeroplane car park thing. I don't even know what that's called. I have no idea how airport systems work. I mean, I've not been abroad that much, so I've not spent much time kind of observing all how airports kind of run. I've only been like abroad like 4 times, like once to Florida, 3 times to Paris, but I will be jumping on a plane to Paris in about a month's time for Disneyland, obviously, as I mentioned in the last video, so maybe I'll see something then, I don't know, but I'm kind of more focused on the actual getting my flight, making sure I get my flight, and kind of the anticipation of the trip rather than kind of observing how the airport works. But you never know, on the flight back home there may be a bit of a longer wait, so maybe I'll pay more attention. But yeah, anyway, so you walk through the towers, you have this aeroplane car park as I call it. You can see the towers actually being built in there, in fact, because it took me so long to talk. So it looks like my plan from earlier isn't going to be a thing anymore. It looks like I'm going to be talking as I'm building. But yeah, you see me going into night mode there because I'm adding kind of the lights to the towers. But yeah, so you walk in through the archway, you've got some aeroplanes, you've got some kind of rocky queue line because I didn't want it to look, I don't know why I put rocks in, I didn't know how to, there's no really texture for like tarmac. Hopefully Planet Coaster invent that. Also, if you do know how to kind of do tarmac or make it look good, then please put comment below. So you go past a load of aeroplanes, you go under that kind of walkway that I showed before between like a maintenance shed and part of the airport. It's very probably a bit small, that maintenance shed, but oh well. So you go kind of past there, then you go into like the building that's meant to be like the check-in area. It's a small airport, as you can see. It's meant to be filmed to kind of like the Longshore Studios airport, because I'm doing a series apart like at this resort called Longshore, where it's like a series of islands. I know it's kind of like a bit like Disney, but I'm kind of doing two other parks to this resort. It's going to have 3 parks, but 3 all very big parks. This is probably going to be the smallest park. So one's going to be like a Magic Kingdom park with themed areas. This isn't going to have themed areas of such. And then doing another park that's like kind of a amusement park, which is more kind of ride intensive. Like, not all, like, especially the first park I'm doing is not going to be actually that ride intensive. It's more about the theming and the whole experience. This isn't going to be so ride intensive either because of the studios, but kind of that last part's kind of for the big thrill seekers. It is going to have a bit of theme, you know. It's going to be a bit like, hopefully it might end up looking a bit like Cedar Point, which is an amusement park that I've never been to, but I really want to go to. That's, it is an amusement park, but it's actually looked really nice. It's very well presented, and it even has the odd show, which I'm hopefully going to get in my other park. So I think for my aim for the third park, I might as well talk about it, is I'm going to kind of have one side of the park that's more a bit themed, and then the other side of the park, which is like your old classic pier style kind of seaside part of the park, which is probably even more tacky kind of thing than Blackpool Pleasure Beach. But you know, it's a classic, it's going to have some classic rides. In a lot of these newer theme parks, we don't have the classic rides because we kind of have rides that are better, but you know, the classic rides started off everything, so it'd be nice to kind of have them there as a bit of an, I don't know, legacy, is that the appropriate word? Anyway, you go into this check-in area, small airport, You got your check-in desk, your security, you can see a few bags around. Like I said, it's loosely themed. And then you go through, like, kind of a hatch thing. I don't know why I put it there. It just looked kind of cool. It's more of a sci-fi thing, I don't know. And you go, like, outside, and then you go up some stairs, and then into the station, which I think is a nice station. And then, yeah, that's it. You get on the ride, which I think is quite nicely lit. And that. So you can see me here building the station. You're going to see me, like, put bits in. No, not the state. The queue line, sorry. The indoor queue line. You're going to see me take bits out, put things in, because it took me a long time to do this queue line. And that's mainly because I didn't really plan it very well, to be honest. I put it right at the edge of the park, but that was actually a really bad idea, because I didn't actually have room to put in all the walls. So what I ended up doing is actually, like, moving the queue line, like, back, kind of. And I think, yeah, I ended up just doing, like, an outside thing in the end. So even though this ride actually looks like it's nearly finished, you'll see I come across a bit of a problem just about there, because that's actually the boundary to the park. So yeah, but hypercoasters, it was an appropriate place to put it. Hypercoasters aren't often in the middle of the park, especially with studios partly one of me. They're often either at the very back of the park or the very front of the park or side. They're right at the kind of the park boundary, and a good example of that is Silver Star at Europa Park. Actually, part of that roller coaster is actually built on the park's car park. Europa Park is a park that I hope to get out to in the future. But yeah, Silver Star is actually built right on the park's, like, border. And you can see kind of the car park kind of there. But it kind of was an appropriate place to put it, kind of, because it is themed to cars. I don't know if the park, like, thought about that when they were getting planning and that, whereas that's where they want to put it. But whether that's got anything to do with that, but yeah, they put it in the car park. Anyway, that's about all I can say about this ride, to be honest. What I'll do is I'll shut up for a bit. You can enjoy some music. I've not decided what music I'm putting in yet, whether it be theme park music or some no copyright music. Anyway, hopefully it's you're listening to some good music right now, so hope you'll enjoy the music. I'm sure a lot of people will enjoy it. Yeah, the reason I'm putting the music, if you wondered, is because it's just something in the time lapse. When you do a time lapse, you obviously can't have the sound of the game, because it just sounds stupid, and in Movie Maker it actually takes that away. So yeah, that's why I'm putting the music in instead, if you wondered that. But anyway, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shut up for a bit. You can enjoy the music, and I'll come back when I start to build the exit. See you guys in a minute. Thank you. Okay, so we've started to build the exit now. And this is probably actually the part of the ride that I'm most disappointed in myself building it. And now I think back, I did actually record this episode a long time before this has gone online. Kind of before I had all my exams and that, because I wanted to get it out as quickly as possible. And I thought if I build the ride, this ride kind of start after my exams are done, it's going to take a long time, because even though it's not the most heavily themed ride, this actually was still hours of work for me. Probably took me about, I don't know, a week or two with being kind of the weekdays, kind of not doing it. I don't know how, I can't remember how long it took, but it took actually probably not too long considering, but yeah. I still remember spending a long time on this ride. Reasonably long time, that is. So the reason I'm disappointed is because, as you can see, I am building basically a generic stone path like you would get on any roller coaster, like whether it be Alton Towers or what. And I'm not trying to diss Alton Towers here. You can see I've actually gone back to the actual queue here, adding in some of the theming, like the airport trolleys and security scanner, etc. But I will go back to the exit, but since I started building it, I wanted to tell you why I'm so disappointed in it, and I'll continue to do that whilst I'm building this. So yeah, there you go, you can see me again taking away the queue line wall there, because obviously, like I explained before, with the park boundaries and that, you can then see me covering up the station, because that looked really ugly before, but that white kind of wall makes it look a bit better. So yeah, I'm just disappointed, because now I thought back, I could have added in like one of those conveyor belt systems. I could have added in a bit congratulations, because you kind of see this VIP kind of poster and you're thinking, what on earth is that all about? Is that just a random bit of theming in it? It doesn't really fit with kind of the storyline or the loosely based storyline of this ride. So I'd like to in the future add a bit female bits around this ride. I think I just lost motivation with it, to be honest. I was quite impressed with the coaster design, even though maybe it breaks some of the rules of traditional Arrow hypercoasters, but you know, it's a studio's park, things can be a bit innovative. You know, then again, Arrow's actually gone defunct, so they're no longer building hypercoasters. It's B&M doing the hypercoasters now, and I think the Mac do hypercoasters. I'm not sure if Mac started building hypercoasters. They possibly did, I can't quite remember. I need to, now all my exams are done, look a bit more into kind of coaster manufacturers and that, so I can kind of tell you guys these things who might be wondering. I know not all of you are going to be bothered, but for those who are wondering. So yeah, that overbank turn is an example of that. So yeah, I could have done like a checkout desk. Well, not checkout, I mean the conveyor belt system. Could have done like a corridor going out with posters saying congratulations and that. Hope you enjoyed your flight. All that kind of stuff. But no, at the time I just didn't think so. So luckily, when I was building this, you can see the security scanner there with the fences. When I was building this, actually, yeah, I just lost motivation. And yeah, I just ended up building that like rocky path. But luckily, I used the rocks for it that you can actually take away instead of like using painting, like terrain kind of paint. I used like the rocks that you just place down and then you can then delete. So it's going to be an awful lot of work for me getting rid of those rocks when I decide to, but maybe in the future I'll get the motivation to build a better exit to the ride. But I think I'd like to build a few more rides first that are a bit more relevant to the park, kind of like, you know, this is a good ride because there's going to be a whole entrance area with, I don't know, not like a port, but maybe like transport systems. Like I'm going to have the tram touring there, so I'm going to have a bit of a transport hub kind of system going on around kind of the studios. I'm going to have like themed streets with like signposts to the different areas. So, you know, this ride does fit. It will fit even though it's not that themed. And it's probably actually, apart from the tram tour, which is going to be probably what I'm actually going to be building next episode. I mean, if you've watched next episode before this one for whatever reason and you've seen something, then yeah, maybe. Yeah, then you'll know if I built the tram tour, sorry. And, you know, if you've seen, if you can see it. Because obviously this, it'll be a long time till the next episode is posted for those of you who are watching before it's up. But don't worry, it will be there soon because the tram tour is going to be one of the highlight rides of the park. It's not going to be like, the theming on that is going to be, there's going to be intense theming on that. So you can see me now, we're now coming kind of to the end of this ride and just adding in the final touches, lighting up the coaster at night. This is what I was talking about before, you know, it looking good at night. So, you know, this is what I meant by that. So yeah, we're starting to come to the end of this roller coaster now. So hope you enjoyed it. I will post a separate POV of this ride. And yeah, thank you for watching. Just adding a few like last kind of lights now. I think it's important that this looks good at night because obviously it, because it's kind of on the skyline, it's gonna make kind of basically just everything look better. Anyway, I'm kind of losing my words now. I forgot to mention that there is going to be a POV, switching back today there, there's going to be a POV at the end of this video, which you are going to see in a second, of a front row ride on this coaster at daytime. I'm also going to do a POV at night time and in a separate video, and in addition to that I am also going to do a full POV of the ride. So I open the park, there's guests from the guest's perspective, I can't say that, perspective. There's also like a lake that you're gonna see in that video as well, that I also built, or I'm gonna build. Anyway, I've got the path with the fence already. So anyway, that's the end of this episode. Thank you for watching and I'll see you all next time. Bye.